Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Monday of Holy Week. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Contend, O Lord, with my contenders. Fight those who fight me. Take up your buckler and shield. Arise in my defense. Lord, my mighty help.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that though in our weakness we may be revived through the passion of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one with whom I am pleased, upon whom I have put my spirit. He shall bring forth justice to the nations, not crying out, not shouting, not making his voice heard in the street. A bruised reed he shall not break, and a smoldering wick he shall not quench. Until he establishes justice on the earth, the coastlands will wait for his teaching. Thus says God the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spreads out the earth with its crops, who gives breath to its people and spirit to those who walk on it. I, the Lord, have called you for the victory of justice. I have grasped you by the hand. I formed you and set you as a covenant of the people, a light for the nations, to open the eyes of the blind, to bring out prisoners from confinement and from the dungeon, those who live in darkness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
When evildoers come at me to devour my flesh, my foes and my enemies themselves stumble and fall.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Though an army encamp against me, my heart will not fear. Though war be waged upon me, even then will I trust.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Verse before the Gospel. Glory and praise to you, O Christ. Hail to you, our King. You alone are compassionate with our faults. Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
6 days before Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, where Lazarus was, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. They gave a dinner for him there, and Martha served while Lazarus was one of those reclining at table with him. Mary took a litter of costly perfumed oil made from genuine aromatic nard and anointed the feet of Jesus and dried them with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the oil. Then Judas the Iscariot, one of his disciples and the one who would betray him, said, Why was this oil not sold for 300 days' wages and given to the poor? He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief and held the money bag and used to steal the contributions. So Jesus said, Leave her alone. Let her keep this for the day of my burial. You will always have the poor with you, but you do not always have me. The large crowd of Jews found out that he was there and came, not only because of him, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. And the chief priests plotted to kill Lazarus too, because many of the Jews were turning away and believing in Jesus because of him. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now today, as we go into our Holy Week, no, and the final day, so to speak, of preparing for the Easter Triduum, I'd like to invite you to reflect on the three personas, no, so to speak, in today's Gospel. No. The first persona is the crowds, no? And then the second would be Judas, and then the third Mary, no? So when you take a look at the crowds, no, it was a mixture of curiosity, and yet it was a curiosity that led to their believing in Christ. So they were there, not just because of Christ, but because of Lazarus. No, remember, this was after Lazarus was raised from the dead. No, so that word got around. No, that Lazarus was raised from the dead, and the Lord was dining, no, in the house of Lazarus. No, so here you have that first type of person, so to speak, no, the ones who were curious, but also their curiosity led them to conversion, as the Gospel says at the end, no, that people were turning away and believing in Jesus because of Lazarus, no. So that first set of persons, or the first persona in our Gospel for today, no. And then the second would be Judas, no. Judas was again, as the Gospel describes him, no, the Gospel puts him in very bad light, no, that he was selfish, he was a thief, and then he was a hypocrite, no, because he criticized Mary for spending and for using an expensive perfume to wash the feet of Jesus, to anoint the feet of Jesus, no. And so there you have Judas saying that this should have been given to the poor. And then the Gospel tells us, but he did not care for the poor, no? It was more out of his self-interest, no? Because as he himself said, that this is 300 days' wages, no? And that would have been such a big, big amount for him, from which he could steal, no? So that second type of person, no? And then the third and final point, or the third person in the Gospel, is Mary herself, no? Mary's devotion to Christ, no? And I think that is what I would like to invite you to center your reflections for this day, no, on the devotion of Mary, no. When you think about this devotion, no, the first thing that you'd like to look at or reflect on is that she gave the best, no? She gave the best of what she had, no? And this was the expensive perfume, no? And very expensive, and yet she anointed the feet of Jesus with this perfume, no? So that was her devotion, only the best for the Lord, no? And the second point about the devotion is that this devotion also, as the Lord himself would say, no, it somehow foreshadowed his impending death, no? And then the third and final point about this devotion is the humility of Mary, no? Washing the feet of the Lord and wiping his feet with her hair, no? So that humility, that amazing show of humility and devotion, no? So today I'd like to invite you to reflect, no, as we enter Holy Week, no, as we enter Holy Week. Of course, we look at the two personas, no, the crowd and then Judas, no? But perhaps to focus on Mary's devotion and to ask ourselves, what is our own devotion to the Lord, no? Yesterday we were talking about making the choice, no, to enter the core of a relationship with Christ or to stay in the periphery, no? And perhaps we could include that in our reflections for today, no? Does our devotion lead us to take the choice, no, to enter the core of the relationship, which is the cross and resurrection, no? To give and to offer to the Lord in our relationship with Him, to offer the best of what we can offer, no? And that is total devotion and commitment, no, to the cross and resurrection of Christ, the core of his own mission, the core of his relationship with his Father, and to which we are also invited to make that the core of our relationship with the Lord. So that consideration, no, in terms of offering and giving the best to the Lord, no. And then with regard to Mary's foreshadowing the death of the Lord, her devotion foreshadowing the death of the Lord, no? Remember, later on, she would be one of those who would, in a sense, be totally devoted to the Lord, no? She was someone, no? Remember, the women were the ones very, very devoted to the Lord, no? And this anointing foreshadowed the death of the Lord. And Mary, I think, was very sensitive, no? Very sensitive to that, no? And of course, the humility that she showed, no? Is again, for me, a sign, a very tremendous sign of devotion, no? The devotion that led to her humility to wipe the feet of Jesus with her own hair, no? Siguro mahalaga na makita natin yung iba't ibang mga persona, no, dito sa ating ebanghelyo ngayong araw, no. Sabi nga natin una yung mga tao, no, yung mga crowd, no, na sila ay namangha sa Panginoon, no, na sila ay nagsimula sa pagkamangha at pagka may interest sila, kumbaga para nga sasabihin ng iba din parang medyo marites yung crowd, no, curious sila. Curious sila dahil yung pagbuhay muli ng Panginoon kay Lazaro, no? Pero makita din natin na dahil dito ay nagkaroon din ng pagbabalik-loob sa Diyos. Sabi nga ng Ebanghelyo, no, na nag-alala yung mga religious authorities, no, yung mga punong saserdote, at gusto na rin nilang patayin si Lazaro kasi nga maraming mga Hudyo ang naniwala sa Panginoon dahil kay Lazaro, no. Kaya nga itong mga tao na bagaman nagsimula sa parang ano ba to, 'di ba? Parang curiosity na naghantong ito, no, sa pagbabalik-loob o pagkakaroon ng pananampalataya sa Panginoon, ano. Tapos yung pangalawang klase ng mga tao dito ay si Judas, no. Na makita natin yung kanyang pagkahipokrito, no. Na pinipintasan niya si Maria dahil nga ginamit yung napakamahal na langis at pabango, no? Pero ito ay hindi dahil, sabi nga, pero sinabi pa niya, hindi lang yun, sinabi pa niya na, ay sayang, dapat binigay ito sa mga mahihirap. Pero alam natin na hindi yun ang tunay na dahilan, ano? Kundi siya nga ay kumukupit, ano? Dun sa yaman, dahil siya ay ingat yaman ng Panginoon, ano? So, yung pangalawang klaseng tao dito sa persona dito sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw. At yung pangatlo, at yung nga sabi natin, pag nilaya natin, ito yung pinakamalalim na klase ng tao dito sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw, si Maria, no? Yung kanyang debosyon sa Panginoon. Isang debosyon na nagbigay ng inspirasyon sa kanya na ibigay ang pinakamabuti, pinakamaganda sa Panginoon, yung pinakamahal na langis, ano? At pinakamabangong langis. At bahagi din ng kanyang debosyon ay dahil sa kanyang debosyon, ano, sensitibo siya sa galaw ng buhay ng Panginoon. Kaya ito rin yung kanyang paghugas ng paa ng Panginoon, pagpunas, pag-anoint ng napakamahal na langis, ay ito rin ay parang pahiwatig, ano, yung darating na kamatayan ng Panginoon. At yung pangatlong punto ng kanyang debosyon ay yung kanyang pagiging mapagkumbaba ni Maria. Na siya ay nagpunas ng paa ng Panginoon gamit ang kanyang buhok, ano. So ngayon pag nilaya natin itong ebanghelyo to bilang paghahanda natin ito sa mga darating na araw ng Semana Santa, ng mahal na araw, no. So today we reflect on this, on in a sense, ano, these three reactions to Christ, no. And hopefully pray that in the coming days our own relationship with Christ will be one that is deepened by devotion. In the same way that Mary was devoted to Christ in this gospel, let us pray that we too more and more may grow in our devotion to the Lord, especially as we approach the great Easter Triduum. Jesus' gentle manner invites us to turn humbly to Him for forgiveness, assured of His compassion. Let us bring our petitions before Him.
That those who are suffering and experiencing difficulties in life may bear their trials with patience, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That prisoners may have the consolation of the Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may come to the aid of the destitute, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. We pray especially for the good health of the Holy Father. And we pray that for all his intentions, especially his intentions for peace. And let's also pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Graciously, O Lord, upon the sacred mysteries we celebrate here, and may what you have mercifully provided to cancel the judgment we incurred bear for us fruit in eternal life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the days of his saving passion and glorious resurrection are approaching, by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished, and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. He gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. We will now offer our new prayer, our prayer for Holy Week.
Prayer for Holy Week. Lord, grant us in this season of grace the courage and commitment to enter the core of our relationship with you and live out in our daily life the pattern of your cross and resurrection. May entering this core renew our faith that you loved us and gave yourself up for us. Let this be our inspiration to embrace the mystery of your cross, through which we enter the threshold of hope that leads to your resurrection. May this week be blessed with days of grace, remembering how much you loved us to your death, leading to our celebrating the joy of your resurrection. May this holy week deepen our prayer that united with you in your passion and cross, we may experience and rejoice in the glory of your resurrection. Amen.
And let us pray. Visit, O Lord, visit your people, O Lord, we pray, and with ever watchful love, look upon the hearts dedicated to you by means of the sacred mysteries, so that under your protection we may keep safe this remedy of eternal salvation, by which your mercy we have received through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat, and let us all have a very prayerful day ahead and a very prayerful week ahead. Salamat po.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.